I made the switch to full 4K video, both for desktop tutorials and on-camera videos, back at the end of 2016. Between the higher resolution and bit rates, and the higher bulk of B-roll being shot with the increase in production value for my channel, my typical store everything locally and archive to little NAS drives as I go strategy just couldn't keep up with my storage needs. I needed a solution. A bigger drive? Not enough. A petabyte server? I wish. A realistic solution was needed. I needed a disk station. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, today reviewing the Synology Disk Station DS916 Plus, a 4-bay plus expansion capability NAS with a quad-core Intel Pentium processor and 8GB of RAM. This is a beast of a NAS on its own, and I've got mine loaded up with 4 6TB IronWolf Pro hard drives, which were generously donated by Seagate to sponsor this video. Synology has sponsored tutorial content on my channel in the past, but is not paying for this review, seeing it before it is posted, or anything like that. This is still a standard review for me. For my configuration, I decided to go with Synology's hybrid RAID system and ButterFS, leaving me with roughly 15TB of usable space to store all of that sexy B-roll and voiceover. This thing has been serving me well for a few months now. I reviewed a Synology NAS in the past, and the physical overview is about the same. Great metal chassis, glossy, dust-clinging removable front panel, and some nice rubber feet on the bottom. The front also features a status indicator LED, indicator LEDs for each of the 4 drive bays, a USB 3.0 port, and a power button and power LED. Over around the back, we've got a Kensington lock, power input, eSATA connection for the optional expansion dock, dual gigabit Ethernet ports, and 2 more USB 3.0 ports. You can hook up external hard drives or flash drives to these ports and add additional storage or run backups. This is an important part of my workflow, as my main working video data resides on the internal drives and my finished project's footage archive gets moved to the external drives. The NAS's killer feature is a crazy powerful Synology DSM, or Disk Station Manager, operating system that runs on it. This is like a full-fledged computer operating system with a package manager, control panel, and everything. It lets you install your own line of apps to meet your needs, media servers, email servers, wikis, and so on. I love this software. It's the same setup I used to configure my router from Synology that I reviewed previously. It makes managing the NAS so much easier. Not only can I manage the file system, apps, network traffic, and so on, but there's even a special health monitoring tool built in just for these IronWolf Pro hard drives. This lets me view power on time of the drives, temperature, smart status, and so on. Then you can run a dedicated IronWolf health scan to test each drive, spitting out an output code used to diagnose problems if something is wrong with the hard drives. The Seagate IronWolf Pro hard drives also come with a 2-year complimentary rescue data recovery service, which is great reassurance that your data is safe. One more detail that I wanted to mention is that this NAS is running on a Pentium processor and isn't vulnerable to the Atom SoC burnout issues that some NAS devices started experiencing last year. I have the DS916 Plus hooked up with both Ethernet jacks to my big Netgear switch and my server rack from my $15 server rack adventure videos, and it acts as my edit drive. All of my active footage for ongoing shoots gets stored on here, currently occupying about 9TB. I also store my video resources such as background music, sound effects, intros, lower thirds, and so on here, too. I have folders divided up between active projects for projects I'm currently working on, finished projects for projects that I've edited and uploaded but haven't backed up to Amazon Cloud Drive yet, vlog storage to keep our vlog channel stuff separate from the main channel's footage, and a few other folders. I also sync my phone's photos and videos to a mobile backups folder via Synology's DS File app via a sponsored tutorial I released a couple weeks ago as well. Click the link to learn more about that process. I also have 2 USB 3.0 drives connected to the DS916 Plus. One contains my software archive along with some scrap files that I haven't sorted yet, and the other contains my footage archive for video projects and my YouTube uploaded final export archive. Sadly, this isn't a complete archive as I lost quite a bit of footage last year, hence my locking down and archiving and backing up data. This all gets shared over my network. All local computers can access it, which is incredibly handy. Better yet, I actually edit from this NAS. Yes, all of my active projects stay on the NAS and I edit straight from it. The network transfer speeds I get of over 100 megabytes per second make this super easy. I usually use 1/2 or 1/4 preview quality playback anyway, and I almost never experience any hiccups scrubbing through the timeline in Premiere or playing back edits. I use a local SSD as a cache and scratch disk to speed up edits and renders, and the combined performance allowed me to smoothly and quickly edit and render videos with no performance loss, while taking full advantage of the 15 TB available on the NAS. Honestly, I've been blown away by the performance here. I've experienced no slowdowns at all. Every once in a while, a certain effect may slow down the timeline playback, or it just has a brief hiccup, but it smooths out quickly, and then if I just let it load, it just kind of goes away on its own once the video buffers. I don't have to do any pre-rendering or anything like that, and these are effects, you know, these are issues that happen during local editing too, so it's not specific to editing from this NAS. I just wish other editing platforms had the same optimizations as Premiere does, because editing over the network with Vegas Pro and CyberLink PowerDirector was a very slow and unenjoyable experience. I haven't tried to use Resolve over the network just yet. The NAS doesn't get too loud, and it doesn't beep at me anywhere near as much as my QNAP NAS does. Drive swapping is simple and toolless, like really simple, and easy to set up using Synology's Quick Connect, Find My NAS URL system. Then mounting the network shares in Windows only takes a couple of clicks, and you're off to the races. I guess it's worth reiterating that this doesn't have to be an editing or production NAS by any standpoint. That's just my use case. With the plethora of available configuration settings, packages to install, and so on, it can do just about anything. It even has a Plex server app or their own video station alternative. Plex performs all right. It choked on full 10-bit HEVC files, but did just fine playing back normal 720p and 1080p movie files. For more information about Plex, check my playlist link in the video description. On the whole, this badass little NAS and Seagate IronWolf Pro drives gives me tons of space with the security and reliability to keep my data safe. Plus, the IronWolf Health tool is pretty handy as well. This has been a great experience moving my video footage off of my main rig onto a more centralized network location, and I'm grateful for the opportunity to have this set up. This has significantly boosted my productivity this year while still keeping up with my 4K video production needs. Now I just want to look into getting the expansion bay and filling that up too. One day. If you want to check out the Synology DS916 Plus for yourself, check out my Amazon affiliate links in the video description down below. For more information about the Seagate IronWolf Pro drives and health tools, I have a link for that as well. I'm EposVox, like the video if you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.